It was a resurrection of the idea of witchcraft. And this strikes a responsive chord in human nature.
It's the 1920s, almost 1930s in America. You don't expect to find witches, but the fact is, belief in witchcraft has always been there.
Nelson Raymeyer was a recluse. He lived alone in an isolated area of the Hollow.
Some people thought he was a little strange, but he kind of liked to stay on his farm, sort of keep to himself.
At a real young age, he was taught how to powwow.
Powwow is Pennsylvania German folk healing. Some people will call it magic.
Powwowers today, although we're Christian, we do have those other Christians who feel that what we're doing is wrong, satanic.
Nelson was viewed in the community as trying to do whatever he could do to help people, whether it was your crop or whether it was somebody sick. They knew that once he was there, it would be a turning point.
To be witchcraft is the same as giving yourself over to the devil. Completely.
John Blymeyer was born with a cloud over his head.
It was just one unfortunate event after another with him.
He became obsessed with the notion that he was under a curse.
He went to a very noted witch named Nellie Knoll, the Witch of Marietta.
He thought that he could get her to reveal the identity of the person hexing him.
She told him Raymeyer put a curse on him.
He managed to convince Wilbur Hess and John Curry that they had also been hexed by Raymeyer.
It was decided that they had to act.
It is what it was, an unfortunate incident. And sad to say that a person died.